So that's how I found out you can get diaper rash without diapers.
Yeah, yeah, that makes sense.
Is that an ATF shirt?
Yeah.
You know them?
The ATF?
Yeah, they are the best.
Yeah, man, I know the ATF.
Nice! You like them?
What?
Bro, I love the ATF. I love their work goals, bro.
The ATF, like the federal agency?
Yeah, I love them so much.
What do you mean?
I just can't get enough of them. They are so good at what they do. Unmatched.
Like the gun registration people.
Yeah, yeah. That's just the start of it, though. They also handle alcohol, tobacco, and explosives. They even just started handling arson. Like, what can't they do? What can they not do?
Do you like, work for them or something?
Oh my god, I wish. Hashtag dream job. No, I'm just a fan. Just a huge fan.
It's kind of weird. Like, most people would say, like, they don't like the ATF.
What?
Who says that?
I mean, like, no, man. No, I don't know.
Who said it? Who says that? Who would say that?
Some people might talk about that sometimes.
Who?
Like
everyone, man. Do you like them? Not really.
Welcome to Demolition Ranch. Before me, I have an HM Defense. It's the HM50B. It's a 50 BMG. It is a bolt action, as you can see by the bolt doing the action. It's a big old gun with a 29-inch barrel. There's more to it. We have the handguard taken off of it right now. And we happen to have this DeWalt saw. So we're thinking, like, what happens when a 50 cal and a DeWalt saw
make a baby?
No. When you put them together. We did this with a shotgun. We just slowly chopped it piece by piece to get it smaller to see how short we can make the barrel. And it was interesting. And fine print, when you do something like this, you do need to file it with the ATF to make sure everything's legal, which we did do. Right, David?
All gun laws are an infringement.
You said you were going to take care of the paperwork, I thought. No?
Mikey said he was
going to do the paperwork. Mikey did the paperwork with the ATF, right?
Yeah.
You have it? Mm-hmm. Sweet. This is a receipt from Home Depot.
Yeah, I got the saw and extended warranty on it.
That was pretty smart.
That actually, yeah, I mean, that's not as beneficial as ATF approval on this, but that is good work today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. We just won't worry about that paperwork. Editor, cut all that out of the video. Since this is some slightly sketchy, we're gonna strap it down to this. And this is a Swamp Fox Raider. We just set it on there. We have not shot it with it on there yet, so we're gonna see. Whoa!
Hello. Okay,
now we're gonna miss.
It's totally off. You're shooting at the ground.
No, that's good. We need it tight down in there anyway. We'll just move the front up. We put it in a holder from Caldwell. We have also a chronograph from Caldwell. So we are going to shoot it first, a controlled test, to see with a full-length barrel, if the Swamp Fox is dialed, what the speed of this ball ammo coming out of this gun is with a full barrel, and if it will penetrate 3/8-inch AR-500 steel, which it will. And then we'll start chopping and see when it won't. Okay, 50 BMG, loaded. left-handed bolt operation is pretty cool. All right, we have a string tied to the trigger. We got the gun hooked down to this table. We're gonna get behind a bulletproof wall. See what happens on our control group. We're scientists here. Jenna, put your ears on.
I'm never taking them off. Double up.
Okay. All right. I'll get behind the bulletproof wall. Everybody good?
Yeah.
Firing.
Ooh!
Jeez. We hit the steel. Let's go see what it did. 1951.
Great year.
Feet per second is our control test. Let's see what happened to this. I didn't actually expect this thing to get knocked over. This should let it right through. What, it stopped it? How the heck did that stop it? Dang, I really thought a 50 BMG, because I've shot targets with 50 BMGs or this size.
Yeah, I shot this with a 300 Win Mag and it went through.
Weird. Who makes this one? Is this a Caldwell?
It might be a Caldwell. Oh, no,
Oh, that's
Taylor.
A Taylor Targets.
Okay.
All right, hey, Taylor. You stopped a 50 BMG with something that's not supposed to stop a 50 BMG. That's cool. That screwed up our whole test.
Though. Yeah,
we really needed something to go through. Let's get that llama. Let's get that llama and shoot it. Donut left a llama here on the range. We're going to shoot it now. I have this here so you can see the difference in thickness of the llama versus this one. Because I have a feeling this llama is not as strong of metal. It's a random Black Rifle coffee target that Donut left here. And we're gonna try to put a hole in it. Same exact round, same exact barrel, same exact distance. The Taylor target stopped. I mean, it messed up our target. It's got a huge dent in it now, but it didn't let it through and it didn't ruin it. Can we kill a llama? Llama test, firing. Did the llama survive?
Oh, what? That's more like it.
Yeah, that's, but why were they so different? Those exact same rounds.
Remember in the crank episode, we were getting like 500?
Yeah.
In between
think
our...
this thing's messing up?
It could be.
Not calibrated? If this one goes through now, it's gonna be like, well, that was because it was a fast one.
Let's just go with this one, 3265.
It also did not go through. It hit right here and just bent it, but target remains. We found this in the dirt. It's a shield. It is the Hardcore Defense Bravo shield. It says NIJ level 3++. It says it will stop green tip, 5.56. It also says it will stop a 308. 150 grain, 2,800 feet per second. This thing should not stop a 50 BMG, probably. Everything's stopping. Maybe we got really weak ammo. I hung the shield on the llama. See if we can protect the llama with our level 3++ shield from a 50 BMG. All other factors are the same. Ammo me, beer me some. Get behind cover.
Fire and hole.
Jeez. That's a hit. .3185, the other was a little over 32, so we're gonna say our average for a long barrel, 3,200 feet per second.
I see daylight.
And we have a hole. That is more like it. All right, that went right through. So now, let's chop the barrel and shoot it again. We do not want to make YouTube mad at us, so we can't show y'all how we are going to modify this gun. That's actually strictly prohibited. So we are going to have to blur it so that you guys can't learn how we modify this. Now that you guys have no idea how we did this, let me show you what we did. What I did, I just karate chopped it right here. Okay, we took off about 8 inches plus the muzzle brake. Let's do some testing. Sorry, HM Defense. If our speed with a full-length barrel is 3,200, what are your bets? Put them in the comments below of what they will be now that we have minus 8 inches. I feel like Tonya Harding with this thing. Ah! I want the gold!
My Nancy Kerrigan? That's the name. Yeah.
2,900. 2,850.
8 inches?
Yeah.
We were at 30 what?
32.
So, 50... times 8.
Oh, don't do math. It's all about a gut feeling.
Okay. Well, I think it's going to be a foot per second.
I don't know. All right. Firing! Oh, use that fireball, though, and that's a hit. Cool. Dude, it got way slower.
2577.
Yeah. All right, we're going to go 26 on that one. Let's go see what we got down here. Now we're going to have the opposite problem. It's just going to keep going through. But notice on this, that is a much cleaner hole than this. Probably because it was going slower. This one was going fast. It just ripped right through. So I think if we take off another 8 inches, maybe it'll stop it. Plus, plus.
Plus, plus, plus.
So in some guns, they'll port the top because when the bullet flies through, it vents out the gases up top to mitigate the recoil. So I started cutting, and then I was like, what if I just cut halfway through and ported that whole section of barrel? So we ported the barrel. We're going to run a little side test in the middle of this test to see what a short-barreled ported 50 BMG does. Mostly just interested in seeing the fireball because that last fireball was crazy and almost killed our chronograph. So let's make it worse.
Wait, what's 29 minus 8? 21. 21. This is not an SBR.
True. This is not an SBR yet.
Fire.
Jesus. Ooh, that fireball though. So we cut this thing with a saw going this way. And so it's not really going straight up because of the way we cut it. It's more going this way. And you can see in the slow-mo, it like billowing out this way, all the fireball. Our speed is 1751. It's because before it was building velocity right here. Now it's venting right here. And so the bullet probably didn't build much velocity at all here. So we're down to 1751. Let's go see what it did over here. There's jacket. Oh, it's like stuck in there. Ah, it's got it. Little 50 cal jacket right there. And still another jagged hole. More jagged than that first one. Let's just lop the barrel off now, even more. Okay, so we want to make this smaller now. Hi-ya! What the heck was that noise? How's it doing that? Nope. It like rings when it's on the rubber table.
What if that like, that's the sound you need to put? No?
It's when it's. More experimentation.
Ow.
That is so weird. All right, we chopped off another. This is probably 20 inches.
Yeah, at least.
Probably chopped off 20 inches right there. I mean, the bullet is going to come all the way to here. So we only have this much actual room for it to speed up.
9, 10?
That's 40.
72 14 inches.
14 inches.
It's 5 feet of barrel.
5 feet of barrel. Let's go ahead and see what happens. Oh, we got an error. Check this out. Boom. Okay, we have a shorter barrel, and we're going to fire it at the llama and see what happens. Fire in the hole. This is going to be not quiet. Ears?
Here we go.
Shoot. Oh. We might have missed, or is that a hit? Oh, that is a weird hit.
Oh, at the top. Yep.
So it was shooting like a foot low after the last one, but I think it's because it the way it was ported. But I think that one hit like exactly where I was aiming. I aimed it way high this time. We got an error. I think after watching slow-mo, it was because a fireball just engulfed this thing. Probably not ideal. So we don't know the speed. Let's go check this out. I think it was pretty slow. Stopped it.
Whoa, what is this?
Oh, this is the outside level of this, or layer of this plate. What is it? It cracked all the back level layer off.
Oh yeah, wow.
That was the other ones. We didn't even notice that. It was destroying all that before. But anyway, now that we only have like an 8-inch barrel, it does not pick up enough speed to go through this plate anymore. Cool. Same size barrel. We moved the chronograph out front, so hopefully we can get a reading. And this time, we're gonna put a black tip in there. So this is an armor piercing round. So we should have the same velocity as before, but with a theoretically better penetrating bullet. But will it be enough? I don't know.
Let's find out together.
Firing. Jeez. Error. We did not get a reading on our chronograph again for some reason.
Ooh, it was a hit.
I think it's a hole.
Yep. So that went through. Did it go? Oh, it's stuck in it. Well, that's just jacket. Yep, never mind. So it peeled the jacket off, and it actually did poke a hole in this thing too. So even with hardly any velocity, that AP round was still trying to go hard through there. All right, enough messing around with this long barrel. Let's get it short. I'm gonna start buying 50 cals and making wind chimes out of their barrels. All right, here we go. We have a little snub nose, a little snub nose sniper rifle. So ideally we can get a velocity. I'm not sure, we might've just fried that thing by shooting fireballs all around it. I don't know, we'll see. Also, it's probably a bit of a shockwave. Maybe those electronics aren't made for, you know, 50 cal blast just going off all around it. We'll see if we can get a velocity. If not.
Is the red dot still on?
It's still on. The Swamp Fox is working. I see a dot. The accuracy of this may be impaired because I think the bullet may stick out of the end of the barrel. Let's find out.
Oh, no. Oh. Oh. Like a little red rocket. There are some rifling.
Yeah, still is rifled, so we'll get a little spin.
This is problematic.
Let's fire it. Here is how you shoot a 50 BMG super slow, but have a really big fireball. Maybe. We'll find out. All right. Negative barrel. Test one. Oh, that was our freaking chrono. What happened? Oh, man. Turns out there's zero accuracy when you don't have a barrel. Barrel looks fine. See, I wonder if there's like unburned powder or anything in here. No? I didn't see a fireball, did y'all? To the slow-mo. Since we can't aim this thing at all, what if we just put a steel plate right in front of it and shoot an armor penetrating round at it? The question is, will this dent it at all? It's armor penetrating, but I think it's going subsonic because of how well we could see it on slow-mo there. You could see the bullet flying out. There wasn't a whole lot of flash because it wasn't compressing all of that explosion. So, oh man, just all you can see is the black tip sticking out. Mikey. We're definitely ducking because this one's for sure coming back at us.
Firing.
It was a hit. So when we cut it the last time, I accidentally dumped metal shavings all down in here. So that needs to be cleaned out now. Well, that might be a good place to stop. Let's see what we got here. Oh, I forgot we just painted this. Yeah, I mean, it hit, but it didn't do anything.
The keyhole.
Yeah, that might be what that is. But it also could have just hit and gone sideways.
That's true.
To the slow-mo. We have the technology.
We have the technology.
We have shirts. Check them out. Link the description below. If you spend over $50, we're going to pick someone who spends over $50. We're going to put these in three different packages. So someone will get the muzzle brake end. Someone will get the ported barrel, and someone will get the big thick boy. We're just going to sign these things and drop them in your order. So if you order a few shirts and you wonder why your package weighs a ton, not like that. It's because I put a big black rod in there. Not like that. We decided to get a brand new barrel for this gun. So we were going to order one, but they didn't have it in time. So we just taped the pieces back together. No, it's a different day. We were looking at this, all these pieces. We were like, what if we just taped them back together? So we taped them on, the three sections onto the gun, and we're just going to fire it one more time. I wanted to give y'all one more thing to see what happens. Now, here's what we're really betting on today. Will it hit the cinder block? Will a projectile fly out of this, hitting our cinder block? or will it just explode the barrel and the bullet will go who knows where? We all came here today to find out. Run. All right, so what do you think? Do you think it's going to...
I think
the center block is broken.
I think stuff comes out of the front. Yeah, by the barrel being maybe munched.
I think it gets broken. All right, y'all ready?
I guess.
Firing. Oh. That's if we can find the barrel pieces. They're all here. So the cinder block got destroyed.
By the barrel.
By the barrel. Cool.
You owe me a taco.
So I wonder if we can see through this barrel or if there's a bullet stuck in it. That one you can see through. And this one you can see through. The bullet went through. Check that out. All right, now we know. The porting probably helped too. Boom, 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 boom. But it's more like boom. It's still heavy. Sweet. All right. We effectively made this gun pointless. But it's not about that. What's it about, David?
I really think it's about the journey and the friends we made along the way.
Yes.
And this gun does matter to one person, and that's the ATF. And if we didn't do the paperwork, they were going to come and kill our dogs.
Thanks for watching Demolition Ranch. I love you! I'll see you next time! Paperwork, let's go. Open up! This video.